Hello. In this video, we will see pathophysiology of myasthenia gravis. First, we will see relevant physiology. And then we will see pathogenesis of myasthenia gravis. Let's get started. This is neuromuscular junction. This is presynaptic nerve terminal. And this is muscle. Nerve terminal has acetylcholine stored in the vesicles. And postsynaptic membrane has nicotinic receptors. When the action potential comes, acetylcholine is released into the synaptic cleft. Then it acts on nicotinic receptors and opens the channel. This results in influx of sodium. This causes depolarization and eventually muscle contraction. So this is neuromuscular transmission. There is one more thing to know. This is thymus, a gland involved in immunity. It has muscle-like cells, including the receptors. Normally, these receptors are identified as body's own proteins. So no immune reaction is triggered against them. This was all under physiological condition. Now let's see what happens in myasthenia gravis. Myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disease. Commonly the problems start with thymus. An abnormal thymus identifies acetylcholine receptors as foreign proteins. So antibodies are produced against them. These antibodies block the acetylcholine receptors at neuromuscular junction. They also induce destruction of the receptors and damage the muscle membrane. So number of functional receptors is decreased. So acetylcholine fails to produce action potential. This ultimately results in weakness of muscle contraction, leading to various manifestations of myasthenia gravis. Based on this pathophysiology, treatment of myasthenia gravis is aimed at either reducing immune attack or increasing acetylcholine concentration at synapse, so it can activate remaining normal receptors. We will study them in detail in a separate video. So that was all the detail. In summary, myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disease due to antibodies against acetylcholine receptors at neuromuscular junction. They impair neuromuscular transmission and cause muscular weakness. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.